Hello, my name is Austin Fire, and welcome back to Mass Effect, as I hardly remember what the hell I was doing. Alright, so these are the two things I have assignments for. Caspian just happened to be a happy accident, I suppose. But yeah, so I'm probably, at the rate I'm going, I'm not going to finish Mass Effect 1 before Andromeda releases on the 21st, which is literally, what, 5 days away from recording, that is. But, we're gonna do our best. I'm gonna see if I can't power through. I know I've been very distracted lately. You know, I still have my trip to worry about, you know, my move to worry about. Frankly, I've barely packed up anything yet, but I don't have all that much to pack up, truthfully. I'm just more concerned about how many trips it's gonna take to actually get everything I own moved, but whatever. Alright. Let's get to it. Inti. Like, Tantalus Inti, or, well, no, it's still an I, not from a lot. Anyway, Inti is a terrestrial planet with an atmosphere composed of ammonia and helium. Its surface is mainly composed of sodium oxide with deposits of magnesium. Its density is rather low, leaving the planet tidelocked to Metano. Inti is an unremarkable world, drawing little more than a cursory scan for surface pirate anchorages when Alliance patrols enter the system. Cool, glad to know. Let's go to Chaska. Okay, so this is the planet I'm landing on. Chaska is a large but low-density world, fundamentally similar to its inner neighbor, Inti. Like Inti, Chaska is tightly locked to Metano. The same side always faces the sun, resulting in a scorching day side and frozen night side. In a temperate area around the Terminator, temperatures average around 30 degrees Celsius. Combined with the nitrogen-oxygen atmosphere, this slender band of habitable terrain allows limited colonization by humans. Chaska's ring is unique. It appears to be, for lack of a better term, a massive piece of alien installation art. The rings are made of small pieces of synthetic material and are almost invisible from space. Excuse me. From the ground, they catch and scatter light of Metano in picturesque ways. It's not known who created the ring or when. Chaska's very early development, with little more than a few pioneer teams scattered across the surface. Information is being collated about native hazards and ecology, while a massive colonist recruit drive is gearing up back on Earth. Okay, there we go. Jeez. Alright, we'll be back to you in a second, though. First, we check the... Ooh, hello. I found you, metallic asteroid. Time to get me some money and experience, like I need any more of that. I found a large deposit of did I say Herschel system? Well, that's an error. Alright. Apo, or something. A craggy world of igneous and basaltic mountains, Apo is racked by constant geologic activity. While volcanic hotspots are rare, continental plates are constantly piling up new mountains, subducting old ones or causing slips along transform faults. Apo is a dense atmosphere composed of nitrogen and carbon monoxide. Due to the constant earthquakes and landslide activity, surface exploration is not advised. The rubble-covered wrecks of a half-dozen expeditionary ships stand in mute testament to the planet's instability. Alright. Where's the other one? There it is. I like to do this in order. Leave me alone. I know the other one was closer. Alapa is a hydrogen-helium gas giant with an unusual ruby color caused by contaminants in the atmosphere. The world has over 120 moons, one of the highest totals of all known systems. Once full development of Chaska's colony begins, a helium-3 refining infrastructure will be developed in the Alapa system, concentrating on the large ice moon of Kanaraya. That's what I think of that. Anything in this belt? Anything? Oh, gosh. Okay. There we go. Oh, found it! Aha! Rocky asteroid. The asteroid has an unusually sculpted artistic appearance with many long sweeping curves. Prothean data disk! Yay! I completed that! I completed that assignment! Hooray! While scanning the asteroid field in Metano system, you discovered a badly damaged ship. The recon team now found no survivors on board, but they did find a Prothean data disk. Alright, that was the seventh one I needed. Cool. Supe. Supe is large as the composition of an ice dwarf planet, but is unusually large for such a body. It has a trace amount of atmosphere, krypton, and xenon. The frozen surface is dotted with deposits composed of potassium and light metals brought to the surface by cryovolcanic processes. Supe's icy surface was often used as a source of potable water by passing merchant vessels. Since the Alliance claimed the inner system world of Chaska, satellites placed in orbit automatically built any vessel landing on the world for the massive water removed from the surface. Exogeny has had a difficult time keeping these satellites operational. They often meet with accidents caused by impact with jettisoned ship debris. Alright, anyway, survey! Light metal, magnesium. Gotta take your magnesium supplements, guys. Alright, let's go. Let's go to Chaska and do this assignment. I can't remember what the assignment actually was. We are going to bring, Liara and Rex. That's a actually interesting combination. Wait, there's no tech there. I might need tech. Let's bring Liara and Garrus. Yeah. I can't wait to the next game when that's simplified. Like the encryption, decryption dichotomies are so annoying. Or decryption and what is the other one? I can't remember what the other one is. I'm just glad they simplified all the minigames in Mass Effect 2 and 3. I feel like Mass Effect's primary problem is that it's just how much it like overcomplicates things. In addition to the janky Mako controls. Because the controls in the Mako themselves really aren't buggy, it's just the physics are really weird. But it's still like it's definitely like how complex and convoluted it is. You know, I brought this up before, but I know lots of people liked the greater complexity of the original Mass Effect. But at the end of the day, the series definitely was served better by its, by the streamlining of a lot of its systems. Oh, hello, mineral deposit. Just what I was looking for, not that I need anymore. Hey, another mineral deposit! Look at that! My sojourn into the northern part of this map, which I'd never done before, was worth the while. Assuming I can get over these hill. Oh, for crying out loud. Why is there always another action? Why is there always another hill? Alright, anyway. In other news, speaking of other hills, anyone see any previews about Mass Effect Andromeda yet? I have, and it doesn't look terribly promising. And I'm really hoping that I don't regret my decision to pre-purchase that game for $74 that's plus tax of shit. That's plus tax, of course. Shit. I crapped it up because I... Damn it. Hold on. Okay, hold on. I almost got this. Oh, fudge. It didn't look like I was in front of that. Well, it did. It's just I wasn't really paying attention to what I was doing, so I just ran. Can we? Okay. Yep. Nope. I keep running into my marker because apparently that marker is made of solid uranium. That makes sense, right? Like uranium's a heavy metal, so if you had a solid chunk of it, it would be extremely heavy, right? Anyway, alright. What the hell is this tank doing? Why did it do that? What? Speaking of janky Mako controls. Anyway, back to Andromeda. Wow! Why did it skip to the left like that? What the heck? Ugh. Alright, anyway. Yeah, I'm definitely like, like, I'm afraid it's gonna become Dragon Age Inquisition. Again, because I had that problem with Inquisition. You let me leave the vehicle on much steeper terrain than this, I can assure you. But I feel like it might be another like Dragon Age Inquisition in that it's gonna be decent for the most part, but it's gonna have too much going on, because I still haven't beaten Inquisition despite having put like 40 hours into the damn game. Because I just got tired of all the side quests. Like, I got so bored of all the side quests. And I'll get back to it eventually. In fact, I'm thinking of actually restarting by playing Dragon Age 2, because I never played that. But I got the general sense that 2 was kind of skippable because of the way it was so different from Origins. Meant that it really just didn't feel as important as Origins. But I kind of ran into that. I kind of ran into the whole segment with Hawk, and I'm just like, I feel like I kind of need a little more. I feel like I need a little more of the emotional impact in this. I mean, like, I've spoiled what happens. I know what the sacrifice at hand is, but at the same time, it's just like, damn it! I have to go back and play Dragon Age 2 because now it needs to mean something to me. What's that over there? Oh, okay, that's one of the locations I have to visit. Okay. I didn't even realize I was that far south already. See, time flies when I'm babbling like a moron. Yeah, I'm sorry, but there is no way that shouldn't damage this tank. I don't care how light the Mass Effect fields make this thing. There is no way this thing should not be damaged by long impacts, by like large impacts like that. Because it feels like it doesn't take into consideration. You know what? Screw that. I don't need that. I don't feel like climbing this mountain. Well, then again, I'm about to get to the easy part of the mountain to climb, aren't I? Yep, I am. I'm probably gonna do this under fire, but... Tank, thank you. You know, Liara wanted to drive, but I don't know why. I don't know why I let her. Fudge. I don't know. Why did I hit the space bar there? Probably because I'm used to jumping to get out of... Alright, you know what? Screw this stupid mineral point. I'm going over here. What is everything over here? Science facility, civilian structure, anomaly, debris. Okay. Alright, so I can see everything pretty much from here.
Looks deserted.
There's three people here! What do you mean it looks deserted? The people are husks, but you get my point. It doesn't look deserted.
The entire colony must have been transformed.
Transformed? The entire colony was transformed? Alright, let's get out. Let's go. Thanks for telling me that. I probably shouldn't have parked the tank so far away. Oh well, it doesn't matter. Oh, why's my head itchy? Okay, there we go. Well, so thank you, Beeping Noise, for punctuating that. At least I have my shotgun out for this. All right, Lady and Germ, let's do this.
Enemy sighted.
Hello? I mean, I see you guys there, but... Whoa, he just flopped over hilariously. Whoa, that was an explosion. Biotic powers, away! Wait, I didn't click it. Shit. Okay, take that. Oh, you're dead. I was targeting the other guy. That's what it was. He's like, oh, why would you do this to me? All right, let's... Ooh, that's not lift. That is lift. There we go. Oh. Oh, you're exploding. Where are you? Oh, there you are. Hi. Someone help. Oh, that's not helping. What the?
All clear.
Is he okay? That didn't sound good. Ooh, look, a guardian armor for Mr. Vicarian. Let's see if he... Wait, can he equip medium armor? Yes, again. All right, so he's got the... Phoenix. Okay, let's just equip the guardian because the Phoenix is... Why are the textures so poor right now? What the hell? I could have sworn I... Yeah, texture detail is supposed to be high. What the hell? What the hell? What's going on with the textures right now? Why are they so low quality? I mean, I know the textures aren't great in this game, but what the heck? Unless it just didn't load in properly? Yeah, it looks fine right here. Hold on, I'm a little... What the... Why is it not loading in on the screen? Okay, you know what? I don't care. I'm overthinking this. It's fine. Why is there a sludge canister over here? Who just sticks guns in a sludge canister? Oh, whatever. I don't care all that much. Despite my obvious overreaction, I don't care enough. Ah, hello. Crate. Let's see, heavy armor, Survivor 8. I think that's really good armor, if I recall correctly. I think the Survivor series is really good. I could probably put this away, can't I? Watch, as soon as I go through this door, it's gonna be a husk. Nope! Okay. Aid station. I'll take that. Don't really need it, but whatever. And easy decryption. Begin the manual override. Avenger 9, Volkov 9. Alright, let's see. What do I have equipped on Garrus Vakarion? Okay, so it's a Kovayov. That's good. Volkov. Yeah, this is better. Yes. Oh, he had a Volkov 8. I could have given them that too. Oh, well, whatever. Now I think about it. I should probably start thinking about who my final team's gonna be. I mean, I know I still have Vermeyer to do. Vermeyer. Viermeyer to do, but whatever. Also, for the record, I'm probably going to keep this episode a little short. I'm just going to keep it to Maroon Sea. I'm going to do a little bit of, I'm going to do any Citadel work I had to do off episode, and then we're going to just hop straight to Viermeyer next episode. Oh, I didn't mean to do that. Malfunctioning object, medical exoskeleton 8. All right. On to the next building. Okay, let's see if the Mako's parked in the same spot. Yes, it is. Okay. Sometimes I know this game sometimes likes to reset things, not even reset things, but just, like, set things differently from how you left them when you get out of a building on a planet. Yeah, but that's okay. This is totally okay. I don't know why did I say that like that? Vroom, vroom. Alright, so we gotta go to this building. And the last one's on top of that cliff. It looks like there was a way to go up there from the backside where I was. So we're gonna go from that angle. What's that over there? There's another marker over there. Oh, is that the... Oh, that's the cliff top building. Okay. Alright. Guns out. Oh, wait. What do you got, Garrus? Yeah, you know, equip your sniper rifle even though we're going to close quarters combat. That's fine. I just want him to use it at least once. Hello?
Hello? Hey. Hey, buddy. Bye, buddies. Bye. Bye. Bye.
Whoa, what? Oh, it's a sniper rifle. Oh, a sniper rifle just took him out. Whoa! Let's just use our metagel. Oh! Nice shot, Garrus. Good job blasting the thing directly next to us. Nice shot. At least you actually blast the husk that time instead of the explosive container directly next to our bodies. Whoa, there you are. Did you just shoot me? Where? What? Oh, got confused there. Where are you going, buddy? Buddy? That's what I feel like when I see... Shit. Whoopsie, I didn't mean to throw that. I keep trying to reload like it's normal shooter game, and I just keep chucking grenades instead. Alright. There's a crate hidden back over here. Gosh, give me some 9 guns. Give me some tier 9 guns. Tier 9 and 10. We're at that point where I need some 10 guns. Take that. Let's look for supplies. I probably should just skip this part. If I don't say anything interesting, actually, it would definitely compel me to skip the part. All right, moving on. Get into the Mako and let's just go. Actually, it looks like I can get up that side. That there over there, too. Might be a little more convenient than looping all the way back around to where I was. Yeah. This should be easily traversable. Hopefully, knowing the Mako, I'm going to, like, snap off to the right and fall off the mountain on the steepest side. Okay, there we go. Got it. Oh, there are the spikes. They're all them spikes. Better run this guy over. Okay, why did that happen? Hold on. Where are you going? You cowards! Why does it Mako keep doing that? Why does it keep getting down? Please stop shooting the tank, gentlemen and lady. Bullying. Nice try, buddy. But I was gonna beat the crap out of you before you can electrocute or shield. You know, never mind. The door is exactly where I was, wasn't it? Pretty much, yep. If I'd gone the other way, I would have found the door much faster. Why is this... Okay. Things don't look like they went down well in here. I don't know what's giving me that impression, though. Alright. Hello? Pizza delivery?
Kill them all.
Hello? Hello? Oh. Oh, this is not what I was expecting. Oh, they're coming. Oh, they are coming. They're coming in a wave. They are coming in a wave. Gonna fling them around. I don't know what's happening over there, but we're just gonna do that. You know what? Screw it. That's not what I meant to do. I think I took care of it. I mean, truthfully, I don't know how you can say perimeter secured without us actually doing a proper sweep of the perimeter and make sure it's actually secure. But sure, Garrus, we'll base our actions upon your entirely unfounded guesses. Really, an empty chamber? Really? How lazy? How utterly lazy! And a completely empty chamber. No rhyme or reason to it. It's just empty. You see, at least this has stuff in it. Why is the other one completely empty? Oh, I wasn't paying attention to what I was doing. There we go. Yes, I am running out of room in my inventory. I get it. I'm going to sell things to the QA. Okay, yes, I get it. Yes, I get it! Boop, 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 boop. All right. I get it! The Colonial Pioneer team rarely consists of more than a few dozen specialists. It's clear none of them have survived. The Cerberus group is a lot to answer for here. Malfunctioning. Oh my gosh, please stop telling me this. I get it. I get it! And that was my Londa Malari impression. Anyway, Alright, well, I guess there's just a couple more things to check after this, but even then, I can't really check the debris, can I? Shit. Shit, but not that map. Hold on, okay. I'll be back in a moment once I figured out what my course of action shall be, because I'm nearly out of inventory. Well, I mean, I guess I could always melt things down. But I'm always free to do that. Oh, hey, look, it's one of them Prothean pyramids! Let's check it out. What? Oh. Wait, what do you mean, en route? What does that even mean? What does it even mean in this context? Oh, let's see if this is better. I was looking at Omni-Tools for Mr. Vicarian. Chameleon versus Cypher. He doesn't really need it. Begin manual override. Okay. Well, we can reduce that to what we can reduce. Actually, we can reduce all of this. Screw it. Screw all of that. Screw it. Screw it. Screw it. Okay. Anyway. All right. Now let's drive. Oh, hey. Hi. What do we get? Recover artifact. Also, what's in here? Ding. Prothean data disk. Yay! It appears to be in excellent condition. So, is there anything up on top of this? Is the real question. Oh. Oh, we're just gonna slide down, I guess.
Securing point.
Anything up here? Anything? No, nothing? Nothing? I'm not gonna have anything up here? No trippy visions or anything? Oh well. I guess. Whoa, okay, that was unexpected. Guess that's it. Guess that's it for this planet. Let's return to the Normandy then. I mean, we've already solved the mystery anyway, so it's fine. Yep, alright, let's move on. Let's get out of here. Let's get this last assignment out of the way.
and then we prepare for the Empire.
Gosh, I wish I had more time in the day. Clomarthu. Clomarthu is a reducing atmosphere of methane and nitrogen. The surface is hot and mainly composed of sodium with the deposits of uranium. In terms of size and orbit, Clomarthu is a virtual twin of Earth, but utterly lacks life. Interesting. Let's see. Notoclix. What?
Beacon on the planet below, Commander. No message, just a locator signal.
Understood. Really? That's all we needed. Notoclix is a verdant world with abundant water, temperate climate, a thick nitrogen-oxygen atmosphere, and a rich ecosystem. It would seem to be perfect for life. The relatively high percentage of oxygen makes humans feel energized and alive, though it has allowed insects and analogs to grow to frightful sizes. Unfortunately, Notoclix is a case of almost not quite. Thunderstorms are as common as on Earth, but in Notoclix's thicker, oxygen-rich atmosphere, they are deafening and spark constant wildfires. More damning, however, are the large and ubiquitous tufts of pollen that float in high-pressure air. In humans and other oxygen-breathing species, they cause severe or lethal allergic reactions. Oh boy! Well, almost, but not quite, right? Oh, there it is. Hello! I saw that! I see you glinting in the distance there, metallic asteroid. What do you have? The large deposit of palladium. Alco. The geological properties of Alco have been scanned from orbit, but little else is known about it. A fairly typical mix of outer system terrestrial of rock and ice, Alco's trace atmosphere of krypton and xenon. Its crust is composed of silicates of water ice with deposits of aluminum. I almost said the British way. Shit! I'm spending too much time around Tantalus. I almost said that the British way. Unregistered starship traffic has been recorded in the vicinity of this planet. Travel is not advised. Well, too late. I'm already here. And Potaiton. Another small hydrogen helium gas giant, Potaiton's atmosphere contains large quantities of chlorine. Matriarch's writings recovered, but there's still more of those to find. Scans of Potaiton reveal a strange unmanned vessel in orbit around the planet. Tali brought it on board and determined it was an Asari made, but very old. She discovered several ancient artifacts inside the vessel, including one of Matriarch Dilanaga's writings. But what about the others? I want to know about the others! This game is such a tease. It's like, oh, you found one of Matriarch Dilanaga's writings. But what else? What else did you find? I want to know! No! Okay. I don't know why I'm doing that. All right, everyone, remember, masks on, especially you, Tali. Never mind. Ah, yes, this looks like the allergy sufferer's paradise. Look at that. Look at that, it's like a bunch of dandelions just flying around. All right, what do you need? You got the scorpion, guardian, oh, gosh, is there nothing better for you, really? I forgot to, fudge, I gotta go back. We have to go back! I forgot to go to the QM and get rid of all my junk. As I have loads of junk in my inventory right now. I'll be back. Oh, so instead, I'd like anyone to observe the mild absurdity of kind of dropping down in a tank and then immediately returning because you forgot to sell your shit. Just throwing that out there. Like, the absolute absurdity of doing that. It's like, wait, gotta pick us back up! We screwed up! I mean, it's not like this tank... I mean, it's not possible I could just, like, dump all my crap in the tank's hold and probably be fine for the rest of the mission. No, we gotta go all the way back to the ship. Gotta go all the way back to the ship. And, man, apparently I upgraded stuff recently. Alright, anyway. Oh, yeah, I did. Duh. You dumb me. Let's give you a Solaris amp there. All right, let's see. Map. All right, so we're here. There's an anomaly there. There's debris there. There's a science facility there. Okay. Not gonna... Wait, there's something over here. What's over here? I wish to know. A lot of things over here. Oh, Thorian creepers. This makes sense. Securing point. Go! Charge! It's a bunch of Thorian creepers! Knock you down. Knock you down. Knock you... Yeah, never mind. You're not gonna vomit on us today, buddy! Whoa, he exploded. What the hell? Why are the Thorian creepers here? Did they just get lazy and decide to stick a Thorian on this planet for no readily apparent reason? Or are they trying to, like, you know, like, prove some point about the wild, abundant wildlife or plant life or whatever life is on this world? Why are so many of the textures still at low quality? Well, then again, what happened is that I loaded up the game, actually, and all the settings were messed up. Like, all my graphic settings were set down too low again. Yeah, I mean, let me look at that thing. That thing is... That there's someone wedged under me, isn't there? Stop shooting a tank, you idiot! Take that. Whoa. There you go. Oh, hi. There you went! I was wondering where you went, buddy. Oh, I knocked one up there. Holy crap. And Tally just started flying with her explosive shot. Now, you guys handle that while I just open up this crate here. I'm just straining myself by holding my mouse while doing that. All right. Begin manual override. Let's see. Okay. Medium armor even for Krogons. Hardened crate. Ooh, this is going to be interesting. There's going to be something fancy in here, right? Is that fudge? Oh, I'm definitely using Omnigel to open this because I can't even get through. There's nothing good in here. It's only tier 8 crap. I need tier 9s. Tier 9s! Alright, anyway. Take that. Oh, now there's something up on top of this mountain. Oh, yes, because this is where people want to go in the Mako. They want to go all the way to the tops of mountains, right? I'm gonna climb to the top of the highest mountain. Oh boy! Alright, there we go. Almost there. We almost made it. We've almost. Shit. It's not down here. Like, I thought it was gonna be a little pocket, but no, I looked at. Look at that. Why the. Oh gosh, these textures are hurting my eyes. Like, I don't know what it is, but low quality textures tend to hurt my eyes for some reason. For that exact reason, I have trouble playing games from the early 2000s. Because, like, the textures... Like, there's just something off with the textures. I think maybe because aspect ratios weren't, like, really kind of properly set in stone because there were so many different kinds of monitors back then. Why are guns still out? Because of the, like, variety of monitors back then. You know, you had to basically account for a lot of different aspect ratios. You know, you just weren't having, like, the standard kind of squarish shit. Kind of standard squarish monitors and then... Widescreen, no, you had monitors that were a bit all over the place at times. And, like, sometimes if I set things, like, the wrong aspect ratio without realizing it, even when I set it to the right ones, like, the textures would just look really funky in my eyes. And it would cause eye strain. And these low-quality textures are kind of causing eye strain right now. I don't know why it would do that, too. Like, you'd think that less information being fed into the... retina would be better for avoiding eye strain because, you know, there's less things to interpret on the screen. Maybe it's something about the pattern though, or the lack, or like the, I don't know, something about it. Why am I talking so much? I really should just mute myself again until I actually reach one of my last destinations, since I'm currently just bouncing around in mountains. You know, I kind of wonder who thinks this was great level design sometimes, because I just fell from the top of a mountain all the way to the pit of a fuck. Oh, thank goodness. Oh, no, fuck, damn it. Oh, you piece of shit tank. Oh, my gosh. Yeah, like I was saying, I really wonder who thought this was great level design, because they're kind of stupid, clearly. Oh, my gosh. I might as well just go back to the Normandy and come back again. Oh my gosh, this is annoying. Look at this, I'm stuck in the pits of the underworld. I'm literally stuck in the underworld's armpit. Like, what the... Alright, no, screw it, I am going back to Normandy. I'm going back to Normandy and coming back. Because what the hell? I fell off the mountain and I just can't get back up there. Not without lots of trying, and I don't want to keep trying. I want to end this episode so I can actually do other things. I mean, not that I mind doing the episode, it's just, I need to be done with it. You know, the episode needs to be over. So I can move on to other things. Alright, let's see. Alright. So we're going east first. And like I was saying, I wonder who thought this was great map design, given how janky the Mako's controls are. I mean, maybe this is the kind of quality assurance we're used to from BioWare in the first place, you know, this kind of... Hey, maybe this level's kind of annoyingly designed. Maybe we should, like, streamline it just a little bit so that the place doesn't look like the freaking White Mountains of Gondor. You know, so that actually looks like an actual geological formation. Because what is this? Does this actually look like a geological formation to anyone? You know, like, shit, I'm going too far south. Like, really, though, does this look like an actual real geological formation to anyone? You know, it does look too much like, I know, you know, late, you know, like mid to late 2000s game, etc., etc. But I feel like this could have been done a little better. Look at me finding all the faults in the game that I loved so much when I first played it like 5 years ago. Oh, actually, it was longer than that. It was like 7 years ago, wasn't it? Anyway, but I mean, it only applies to some levels too. You know, like these maps that are particularly mountainous are the really bad ones, I think. But anything that's like, anything isn't this silly, I think, is okay, really. Oh, there's an artifact here. There's an artichoke. I mean, fact. Turian insignia. This escape pod is half buried in material that has washed down from the mountains. Though it has obviously been here for centuries, the computer still has power, linking it with your hard suit, you recover a batch of files containing data on the Thracia colony. Oh. So it's literally like the fourth Fire Emblem game. Got it. Alright, let's see if I can get over on roughly this patch of terrain. This looks like, from this angle, like it's just shallow enough to get up. But sometimes gravity decides, hey, the Mako can't get up this. And it's like, but it can bounce around like it's a freaking bouncy ball you get out of the dispensers in the supermarket. Do I sound bitter? Probably. Imagine just like in weird moods lately, like really, really weird moods. That's probably the impending move that's causing them. You know, it's probably all that, because I'm about to do, like, because, you know, I'm about to do a lot of things that are just completely out of the ordinary for me. You know, I'm not, you know, I've never really just traveled like this before, or, you know, contemplated moving like this before. And, oh, don't crush those animals. But yeah, it's making me kind of goofy lately, I guess. Alright, park tank. Let's check out this crashed probe, which kind of really just looks like some, you know, looks like that part off your motherboard, but whatever. Whoa, fudge! Shit! Bypass. Yep, for it. Nope. Take all. Yeah, like, it literally just looks like a component off your motherboard. That's all it looks like to me. Yeah, specifically your motherboard. Yes, you, who's watching this episode. That's definitely not oddly specific at all. Are those enemy markers in the map? Yes, they are. And shit. Why do you keep doing this to me, game? We're just gonna caterpillar up this wall as soon as that one wheel goes over the edge. There we go, got it. Whoa, what? Game. I really just want to go over the most level path in the game. Alright. Here we go, got it. Now we're moving. Now we're cooking. Hey, look, more Thorian creepers. Oh, this is gonna get creepy fast, isn't it? Boom. Go away. Alright. off your on foot. Ow, my butt! What the hell, Tally? I didn't know the explosive rounds could do that. You have to say, Caden, shoot that. It's literally just lying right there. So I could literally just roll that down the hill if I really wanted to. That's great. I love it. Oh, look. Charred corpses. Because everywhere we go, there are charred, desiccated corpses. It doesn't matter what killed them. There is always charred, desiccated corpses everywhere. Alright, so husks in one place, Thorian creepers in the other. That's leaving me with a bit of indigestion right there. Caden, you need some points and things, don't you? I already... Damn it, I just overlapped their skills. I forgot I gave them that just for the sake of... Just for the sake of having... Excuse me. Gosh darn it. Sorry. Hey, shit, Tally! Oh gosh, why can I please stop coughing? Jeez. Let's just bump up your shotgun. And let's give you damping. I didn't even realize I hadn't updated her kit in so long. Alright, save. You save. I haven't even saved much today. I haven't even saved at all actually this entire session. Jeez, that's a mistake. Waiting to happen. Yep, that looks great. Get ready for more Thorian creepers, guys. Yep, same layout as always. Just gonna use the... Whoop, nope. Don't want that. Gonna throw you. There you go. Okay, we're just gonna use lift. Let's go. Why did that work? Let's see. Yeah, use neural shock on that Caden. And no shields. Tally, why can't you use Carnage? What's going on? Nope, don't have AI hacking. Damping. Sure, whatever. Maybe that will keep them from vomiting everywhere. Yeah, that sounds like it's sensible. Whoa, what the? I'm really loving those high explosive rounds she's got. Knock you down. You just look like you tripped, sir. Like, it looked like he just had a really clumsy moment just now. Didn't look like he fell at all. He just had a really clumsy, dumb moment. Gosh, can't wait till sprinting's also a little more intuitive. Hello? You're over here, aren't you? Where are you? Sir? Ah, there you are. Found you. Whoa! Tally's shot scared me. What the hell? Area secured. Man, that was like if a spider like kind of suddenly moves when you're trying to like watch it, and then it just suddenly like skitters around suddenly, and it's like, oh shit! You panic, and it's like, that's what it felt like just now when that jumped like that. The hell is this? I mean, kudos for making a more creative assembly of random scene props, but what in the world is this room even supposed to be? Brawler, Armageddon, alright. All tier 8 weapons still. Of course, I haven't leveled up. Maybe that's why I'm not seeing more tier 9 yet. Yep, more tier 8. I think about it. What's my level? How do I have any more levels? 47, yeah, I got more levels. Alright. Yeah, what is that supposed to be? I mean, again, it's a pretty rather clever use of scene props that we've seen before. But, scared me. See?
I told you somebody would come to investigate that signal. My name is Dr. Ross, chief exogeny researcher at this facility. We've been trapped in this room for days. We're almost out of food and water. You got here just in time.
We're almost out of air, too. I'm Canadian. I come from Vancouver. Actually, Do people from Vancouver have that kind of accent? I don't think so. Anyway, okay, you're...
I need to know what's going on. Why is this place crawling with Thorian creepers?
How do you know about the Thorian?
I killed it, jackass.
I know what Exogeni was up to. I saw what they let the Thorian do to those colonists. So I destroyed it.
Our secret's out then. No point in my lying. You already know the worst. The creepers here were created using altered samples from the specimens on Pharos. We discovered a way to turn them into docile, obedient servants.
That worked.
Going fine until a few days ago. Then all the creepers suddenly went berserk. Only a handful of us made it back into the safety of this room.
Huh. That probably coincides with when I killed the creeper itself.
Why didn't you send a clear message asking for help? All we had was that signal from the emergency beacon.
This is a closed communications base. Exogeni was worried about someone on the project selling secrets to a rival firm or reporting our work to the authorities. We have no direct communication with the outside, only the emergency beacon. It sends a general distress signal to the Exogeni site on Pharos.
Don't mind.
To send a team to respond inside of 24 hours, but it sounds like they had problems of their own.
Yeah, they might have had some problems of their own. Don't mind the crackling sound. I'm just having a bit of a snack here while you talk, ma'am. Actually, I'm cleaning crap I just saw on one of my desktop speakers. Anyway.
Any chance some of the other people at the base might still be alive?
I doubt it. Too many creepers out there. They never stood a chance.
I probably would have seen it too. All right.
Any idea why they turned on you?
Maybe there was still some kind of link between the creepers and the Thorian back on Pharos. The Thorian was unlike any other life form we've ever studied. I can't explain how, but maybe when it died, it somehow set off the creepers here.
All right, well.
I heard all I need to.
Look, I know what we did here was wrong. I'll admit that. But it's over now. There's no sense reporting this to the authorities, right?
Oh, boy.
You were in charge of this project.
Nope.
The safety of the staff was your responsibility. They trusted you, and you betrayed that trust.
Be reasonable. I didn't mean for this to happen. Besides, how does it help anyone if I end up in jail? Normally, Exogeni would have my back, but it sounds like they're going to have their hands full cleaning up the mess on Pharos.
Probably, yeah.
But I've got money. A nice little emergency fund I set up. It's yours if you let us go.
You know what? The problem is that I am rich as shit right now.
You deserve justice. I have to take you in.
That's not going to happen. Open fire. Open fire.
Wow, you sound so unconvinced by your own order there. Whoa.
Go, go, go. Hold the line.
Gonna fling. Whoa, that looked painful. Whoa, you're stuck in the wall, sir. Go. Sir, you are stuck in that wall. Whoa, you are. Exogeni's second-rate mercs proved no match for a trained Alliance Marine. The last of the science crew dead, there's no reason to linger here. What the? He just fell behind the couch. Also, I love how that initial explosion killed both remaining scientists. Like it just flat-out killed them. There was no chance for them to even shoot. They're just like, get into cover! Boom! Ah! Yeah. I like the sound effects there. Shut up. Alright, oh, that was, hold on, I gotta check that. Medical interface, medical exoskeleton. Yes, that's what I like to see. Alright, so that medical exoskeleton's gonna be very handy in the future. Alright, well, we are done here. And I guess that means I'm done with the episode, hooray! I got to kill husks, and I got to kill Thorian creepers, and I shot a scientist in the butt. I didn't shoot in the butt, actually. The explosion killed her. Then I did shoot that mercenary in the butt, though, when he was hanging off the wall, in a complete violation of all the known laws of physics. But hey, you know, it's Mass Effect. We already have a substance that allows us to violate the known laws of physics in every way, shape, and form imaginable. So how bad could it possibly... I left the tank over there! Oh, these are back to normal? What the hell? Okay, that... Well, so much for the laws of physics. That made sense. Let's just get out of here. We need to go. Anyway, I want to thank you all for watching this episode of Mass Effect. If you enjoyed it, leave a like and a comment down below. Be sure to subscribe for more. Also, check the links in the description below for links to my Twitter and Facebook pages. And I'll catch you next time. I will catch you next time as Commander Shepard finally travels to the final location, to the location of a penultimate mission, even, Veermeyer. Until next time, everybody.